What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, Hall of Fame boxer, undefeated, pound for pound king, Floyd Money Mayweather, and Hall of Fame boxer on the cusp of being a Hall of Fame boxer, two-time world champion, turned colorful analyst, boxing analyst, and commentator, Paulie, the Magic Man, Malignaggi, both let their feelings be known that they both felt that Tyson, the Gypsy King Fury, undefeated British lineal heavyweight world champion, defeated undefeated WBC American heavyweight champion Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder very handily and very easily in the first fight. Paulie Malignaggi stated that during the fight, he says at some point during the fight, without the knockdowns, he turned and himself and Floyd Money Mayweather had a conversation sitting ringside and expressed that they felt that they couldn't believe what was taking place, that Tyson Fury was clearly and easily defeating Deontay Wilder. It wasn't even close in Paulie Malignaggi and Floyd Mayweather's eyes. This was one of the easier fights to score. Tyson Fury said even with the knockdowns, himself and Floyd Mayweather thought that Tyson Fury still easily won the fight. So he stated that after the fight, before the announcement, himself and Floyd Mayweather were discussing again that, and in Paulie Malignaggi's head, he said that he already had a picture, painted a picture of how the rematch would play out because of the knockdowns and because he felt like Deontay Wilder could make some minor adjustments. And because he felt he had success with those knockdowns, that going into the rematch, you know, it was going to be, the buildup was going to be epic. So he said he was going through his mind in so many different scenarios and so many different storylines and avenues they could use in the buildup for the rematch. He said, so him and Floyd Mayweather, after the fight, had this in mind that the rematch is going to be exciting and going to be epic because of the two knockdowns. But they both clearly felt that Tyson Fury was victorious in this fight. And thus the reason why when the scorecards were read, and I personally was in the building, Floyd Mayweather exited as soon as the scorecards was read because he was upset with the decision. Paulie Malignaggi stated that he himself was upset with the decision because he said, once again, boxing got it wrong. He said this was an epic failure on the part of the sport of boxing and the judges. So he said that once again, they got it wrong. So he said that Floyd Mayweather exited early, and him himself, he thought, once again, boxing failed the sport and the fans, right? My opinion is this. The two knockdowns give Deontay Wilder, there's only 12 rounds in the fight. The two knockdowns give Deontay Wilder 4 rounds. So you're going to mean to tell me, during the rest of that fight, you couldn't find 2 more rounds to give Deontay Wilder? Because just based off of activity and lack thereof of activity from Tyson Fury and aggressive being Deontay Wilder, you can score those rounds for Wilder because the first round, the second round, the third round, the fourth round, the fifth round was so very close that you couldn't sway in the way of Deontay Wilder for 2 of those rounds. That would make it a draw because the knockdowns, the 2-10-8 rounds, automatically gave him 4 points. It's a point system, right? So 4 points for Deontay Wilder, meaning 4 rounds for him. So that means you add another 2 rounds at the very least out of the rest of the fight. And mind you, that's 4 rounds excluding the fight in its totality, meaning that he won 4 rounds, but they're really 2 rounds. So that means out of 10 rounds, you couldn't find 2 rounds to give to Deontay Wilder out of 10. And Tyson Fury was so dominant in those other 10 rounds that you couldn't give Deontay Wilder not near one of those rounds. I find that very hard to believe. And I find it, it's the storyline that of Tyson Fury that sways people's judgment, right? Now, do I feel like it was a very close fight personally? Yes, it was a very close fight. But I could easily find multiple rounds, and I went over this fight numerous of times, and you could find multiple rounds to give Deontay Wilder just based off the fact that Tyson Fury wasn't active. So he was doing a lot of movement. Yes, he was making Deontay Wilder miss, but he wasn't countering those punches. He wasn't landing anything. He wasn't doing anything. All he was doing was straddling the ropes, using showmanship, dancing, using a herky-jerky style. And yes, Deontay Wilder did miss. That's not uncommon. But Tyson Fury, did he make him pay for those misses? No. So you giving him the round just based off of the fact that he's being elusive, but he's not landing anything? But Deontay Wilder is being aggressive, and yes, he missed, but he's trying to land, and Tyson Fury's not even attempting to land. Those rounds you could give Deontay Wilder, because we hear this all the time, based off of aggression, right? You could give fighters rounds based off of sheer aggression, right? So just based off aggression and some of those, out of those 10 rounds, you can find two rounds to give to Deontay Wilder when you're not so disgusted with the sport that they got it totally wrong with a draw. Okay? So now, let's say Deontay Wilder won the fight and you want to make an argument there. Okay, but to be totally upset with a draw when he won four rounds handedly because of the knockdowns, clearly, those are two-point rounds, which equals four. So they found two other rounds and said it was a draw. That's not out of this world. So Tyson Fury wasn't so dominant that you could just dismiss anything and everything Deontay Wilder was doing. Maybe that's simply because you already have a certain stigma of Deontay Wilder painted in your head, because the agenda that he has no skills and all he has is power comes into play, right? And so with that said, what he does, the little things he does in the ring, gets dismissed because it's already embedded in your brain that he only has power. He doesn't have skills. He's not elusive. What about the times he made Tyson Fury miss? What about those times, right? So I mean, come on. I'm hard pressed to figure for you to say that Deontay Wilder couldn't win two rounds out of 10. Come on, stop it. You know, I believe that it's already, you know, a picture painted in both fighters who happen to be, and it's no coincidence that these two fighters that feel this way, Mayweather and Paulie Malignaggi, are technical fighters with not a lot of punching power. Ironically enough, Tyson Fury is a technical fighter with not a lot of power punching, right? So it's already kind of, there's a bias where you're going to sway in his direction already, because you identify with his style more than you identify with Deontay Wilder's style. So you identify with Tyson Fury's approach more than you identify with Deontay Wilder's approach to the sport. Thus the reason why, of course, you would favor Tyson Fury. Right? There's already, we're only human. So naturally, there's already a sense of biasness towards Tyson Fury because you identify with that of Tyson Fury. So that plays a major role in this. You understand? So, you know, I totally disagree with Floyd Mayweather and Paulie Malignaggi when it comes to them sensing and feeling like Deontay Wilder was completely outclassed from pillar to post, and even with the knockdowns, he clearly lost the fight. No, I can't see that, and neither should they be able to. Now, I know there's a lot of people saying that Deontay Wilder didn't want Paulie Malignaggi at the fight, don't ban him for the fight, and didn't let him commentate. I have no clue about that. I don't know about that, so I don't elaborate on that. I know I saw the lineup, and he's not in, involved. So, you know, but at the end of the day, like I stated, Paulie Malignaggi, Floyd Mayweather, of course, they're going to identify with the skill set and the approach that Tyson Fury brings to the sport of boxing more so than that of Deontay Wilder. So it's not a coincidence that they would favor his style and feel like he was the victor, and very handily, because they identify with that. You understand? So it just is what it is. You know what I mean? But that's all I got for y'all. I can't wait February 22nd, this upcoming Saturday. We're going to get the highly anticipated rematch, the title rematch between Wilder and Fury, and let's see how it plays out. Paulie Malignaggi and Floyd Mayweather both feel like the only way for Deontay Wilder to win this fight is if he made major adjustments and major changes to his approach. I don't believe that's necessary. I think it's minor adjustments that he needs, and he will be victorious. So let's see how this all plays out. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.